Good morning, children. So welcome to the part 4 and the last part of the chapter Bank Reconciliation Statement. In this we are going to start with another topic, that is preparation of amended cash book. Sometimes in the examination a student is required to complete the cash book first and then prepare a bank reconciliation statement on the basis of the balance of amended cash book. So earlier till now what we were doing, we were directly having the cash book balance or the passbook balance and we were directly preparing the BRS. But sometimes it happens the question might ask you to prepare an amended cash book, a new cash book, and after preparing the amended cash book, whatever the balance is there in the cash book, with that you have to prepare a BRS or bank reconciliation statement. This is another method for preparing bank reconciliation statement, the procedure for which is as follows. Number one, first of all, a cash book will be prepared with bank columns only. Obviously, we have to show the bank column only. It will be started by writing down the balance of cash book given in the question. So, whatever balance of cash book bank column will be given in the question, that will be put on the debit side if it is a favorable balance and will be put on the credit side if it is an unfavorable balance. Point number two, all errors that have been committed in the cash book will have to be rectified by passing adjusting entries in the cash book. That means whatever errors have been made in the cash book, those errors will be rectified or corrected in the cash book itself by passing the necessary entries. And normally the usual errors are, number one, overcasting or undercasting of debit or credit column of the cash book. That means usual kind of error is that maybe the debit column is overcasted. That means more amount has been shown in the debit column by mistake or less amount has been shown. Similarly, in the credit column also maybe more amount or less amount is shown. Overcasting means showing more amount and undercasting means showing less amount. The next type of error can be checks issued to creditors but omitted to be recorded in the cash book. That means we have made the payment through check, we have drawn the check, we have issued the check to the creditors or the suppliers, but we forgot to deduct it in the cash book, we forgot to record it in the cash book. Then the third type of error which is usually made is checks deposited into the bank but omitted to be recorded in the cash book. That means we have deposited the check in the bank, deposited in the bank means we have given our checks received to the bank so that bank can clear and add it in our bank account, but we forgot to record it in the cash book. Then the fourth type of error which usually occurs is incorrect amount entered in the cash book. Maybe instead of entering 500, we have entered 50 rupees. Instead of entering 4500, we have entered 45,000 rupees, like that. Then another type of error can be entries on incorrect side or in wrong columns. Instead of showing in the debit column, we have shown in the credit column. Or instead of showing in the credit column, we have shown in the debit column. Instead of deducting, we have added. Instead of adding, we have deducted. So these are the, kind of normal or usual errors which arises. Then last one, any amount recorded twice in the cash book, etc. If you remember, we have done this kind of question in the previous video, that in the cash book by mistake the amounts were recorded twice. So that can be the usual error. Then certain amounts for which bank has given credit in the passbook will be recorded on the debit side of cash book. So there are certain amounts for which the bank gives credit, means banks add in your bank account, which has to be recorded on the opposite or the debit side of the cash book, because debit side of cash book means an addition. So such items are interest allowed by the bank, that means interest given by the bank, then amount directly deposited by customers into the bank, and interest and dividend collected by bank on our behalf. So these are the points, or these are the amounts which are added or credited by the bank in a bank account, which are to be added or debited in the cash book also. Then certain amounts for which bank has debited our account, that means bank has deducted the amount from our bank account, will be recorded on the credit side of cash book because it is a minus item. So such items are interest charged by bank on overdraft, debits made by bank for bank charges, commission, etc., then direct payment made by bank on our behalf of insurance premium, rent, etc., checks sent for collection but dishonored by the bank. So these are the points which, or these are the amounts which are deducted by the bank from our account, or we can say debited in our passbook, which are to be credited or deducted in the cash book. Because credit or credited in the cash book means a deduction in the cash book. Then fifth point, cash book is then balanced. That means after adjusting all these things in the amended cash book is then balanced, and the new balance of cash book is taken as a starting point for preparing the bank reconciliation statement. So after putting on, after adjusting all these errors and after rectifying all these errors in the cash book itself, then the cash book is ultimately balanced, and the balance as per the amended cash book is put in the BRS at the starting point. It should be noted, point number 6, that the following items must not be recorded in the amended cash book. That means these 3 points are the amounts which will not be recorded in the amended cash book, because these will be recorded in the BRS only. So number 1, checks deposited into the bank but not credited by the bank. That means an error by the bank. Then checks issued but not presented for payment in the bank, and any wrong entry in the passbook. So that means any mistake which has been committed in the passbook, or any mistake which has been committed by the bank, or checks have been issued but the recipient has not collected the payment from the bank. So these 3 items will not be treated in the amended cash book. Rather, these will be treated in the bank reconciliation statement only. So these are the rules about the amended cash book. Now let us discuss one more practical question on this basis to make it more clear to you. On 31st March 2015, the cash book of Gopal disclosed a balance of 12,580, and again, since debit or credit is not mentioned, so we will assume it to be a debit or the favorable balance. On checking entries in the cash book with the bank statement, it was ascertained that checks amounting to rupees 18,000 were drawn on 25th March, of which checks of rupees 4,800 were cashed within 31st March. That means 18,000 of checks were drawn. Were drawn means were issued. And since it were issued on 25th March, but it was not presented for payment. So we know that this will not be a part of amended cash book. Just now we have discussed that checks issued but not presented for payment will not be recorded in amended cash book. It will be recorded in the BRS only. And in this question, we are required to prepare the amended cash book. That means the balance as per cash book will be taken as the base. So therefore, we have to remember the rule that wherever the cash book is showing greater balance than passbook, in that case, we will deduct it, and wherever it is showing the lesser balance, we will add it. So in this case, if you see 18,000 checks were drawn or issued, that means we would have, or Gopal would have, deducted 18,000 from the cash book bank column on the assumption that these will be paid. But up to 31st March, that means up to the date of preparation of bank reconciliation statement, only checks of 4,800 were cashed. That means only 4,800 was deducted from the passbook. That means rupees 13,200, the balance amount, 18,000 minus 4,800, was not deducted from the passbook. So that means your cash book is showing 13,200 less than the passbook. So what you will do, you will add this 13,200, you will put it in the plus column while preparing the BRS. This will not be a part of amended cash book. Then point number 2. Out of checks received and entered in the bank column of the cash book for 18,000, 16,000 sent to the bank, but passbook recorded 6,200 after the date. That means 18,000 of rupees of checks were received, and it was, so it means that we have received the check for 18,000 and we have entered in the bank column of the cash book. That means we or the Gopal has thought that 18,000 check will be deposited in the bank and it will be added and credited by the bank in the passbook. So therefore, this 18,000 he has added in the cash book, bank column. But out of these 18,000, 16,000 checks only were sent to the bank for collection. That means 2,000 of checks were not sent to the bank for collection. And the banks, the checks which are entered in the cash book but are not sent to the bank for collection will be entered in BRS and not amended cash book. So that means this 2,000 rupees check which was not sent to the bank at all, that means this addition is false. It, in this case, the cash book is showing 2,000 rupees more than the passbook. So this 2,000 will be put in the minus column while preparing the bank reconciliation statement. Then 16,000 checks were sent to the bank, but passbook recorded 6,200 after the date. That means rest of the checks were credited by the bank in the passbook, but checks amounting to rupees 6,200 were credited after the date. That means after the preparation of BRS. So that means this 6,200 also is shown as an extra amount in the cash book. And we know that bank, the check which is sent to the bank for collection and yet not credited by the bank, it is the mistake on the part of the passbook or the recipient. So it will not be entered into amended cash book. This will also be entered in the BRS. So this 6,200, since it is credited after the preparation of BRS, that means cash book is still showing 6,200 rupees more. So it will be now deducted, it will be put in the minus column while preparing the BRS, not amended cash book. Then point number 3, an amount of 5,000 paid directly into the merchant's account by a customer was not entered in the cash book. So it is a mistake in the cash book itself. That means it has to be rectified while preparing the amended cash book. So this 5,000 which was added in the passbook as a direct deposit by the customer was not added or was not recorded in the cash book. So if it was not recorded earlier, now it will be recorded, and recording in the cash book, any plus item will be put on the debit side and any minus item will be put on the credit side. So this 5,000 as a direct deposit by the customer will be put on the debit side as the direct deposit by the customer, 5,000 rupees, and it will not be a part of BRS. Then the bank by mistake debited Gopal's account for a check of rupees 1,700. Now what the bank has done? Bank has given Gopal a wrong debit of rupees 1,700. That means Gopal's bankers have deducted 1,700 by mistake from Gopal's account. So it is an error committed by the bank. So it will not be a part of amended cash book. It will be a part of BRS. Now bank has debited 1,700. That means bank has deducted 1,700. So that means passbook is showing 1,700 lesser, or we can say cash book is showing 1,700 more, because cash book has not deducted, the passbook has deducted. So since cash book is showing 1,700 more, so in order to bring cash book equal to the passbook, what we have to do is we will deduct this 1,700 from the cash book and we will put this 1,700 in the minus column. Next, on 31st March, cash was deposited into the bank 12,270, but the cashier debited the bank account with 12,270. That means it is an error of amount. So instead of debiting 12,720, the banks or the accountant, what he has done, or the cashier, what he has done, he has debited the bank account, or he has added the bank account in the cash book as your 12,270. That means it has shown 450 rupees, the cashier has shown 450 rupees less he has added in the cash book. So we know it is an undercasting of cash book. So any undercasting or overcasting of cash book bank column will be rectified in the amended cash book itself. It will not be a part of BRS if we are preparing the amended cash book. So this 450 which was lesser recorded or not recorded will now be recorded, will now be added in the cash book. And since it has to be added, so therefore this 450 undercasting of cash book will be posted on the debit side of the amended cash book. Then point number 6, dividend collected by bank on our behalf, 570 rupees, does not appear in the cash book. So that means the dividend which was collected by the bank, that means this 570 rupees is added in our passbook by the bank, but it was not added in the cash book. It was not recorded in the cash book. Again, it is an error in the cash book which needs to be rectified in the amended cash book itself and not BRS if we are preparing the amended cash book. So what we will do, this 570 is dividend collected by bank on our behalf. That means it is added by the bank in the passbook. So it needs to be added in the cash book itself also. So anything which has to be added in the cash book, and if we are preparing amended cash book, it has to be shown on the debit side of the cash book. We will write as to dividend 570. Then the last one, rupees 300 is entered in the bank statement as bank charges. Now in the bank statement means in the passbook, and bank charges means it is a deduction, it is a minus item. So that means 300 rupees has been deducted. So that means this 300 was deducted in the passbook as bank charges, but this was recorded as 200 in the cash book. That means it is an error of amount. So instead of deducting 300 in the cash book, also cash book has deducted only 200. So this means it is an we can say that we have shown 100 rupees less of bank charges. That means we have deducted less. It is an error committed in the cash book, so it will be rectified in the cash book itself if we are preparing the amended cash book. So that means cash book is showing a minus of 200, but the passbook is showing a minus of 300. So the remaining 100 rupees has to be deducted more, and if anything has to be deducted in cash book, it will be shown on the credit side of cash book, because credit in cash book means minus in cash book. Now you are required to prepare the amended cash book and then prepare a bank reconciliation statement. So let us look at the solution. As you can see, amended cash book bank column as on 31st March 2015, date is very very important. The debit side we are showing receipt column, ledger folio LF amount, and credit side we are showing payments LF amount. On debit side we are showing the opening balance because it was a favorable balance, nothing was mentioned, so we have written two balance brought down 12,580, and those items which has to be added in the amended cash book, that will be put on the debit side. That is two customer account 5,000, the amount of direct deposit, then two adjustment of undercasting 450 because it was shown less, then two dividend which was collected by the bank on our behalf but was not recorded in the cash book 570. Then on the credit side we have shown all those items which has to be deducted from the cash book, that is by bank charges 100 rupees which was deducted in less. And after putting all the plus and the minus items on the debit and the credit side respectively, we will compare, and while comparing the totals of debit and the credit side, we found out that the debit side is greater than the credit side, and therefore we have calculated the balancing figure on the payment side or the credit side as by balance carried down, CD. CD stands for carried down. So by balance carried down 18,500. This is the difference between the total of debit side and credit side. How we have got? The total of debit side was 18,600 and total of credit side was 100. So 18,600 minus 100 will be 18,500. This will be the balancing figure. Now this is the balance as per amended cash book with which your bank reconciliation statement will start. And in this amended cash book, you can very well see that the debit side is greater than the credit side. That means the cash book is having a debit balance. Whichever side will be more, the account will set to have that particular balance. If credit side was more, then we would have said that the cash book is having a credit balance. But in this case, debit side is more. Therefore, we are saying, we will interpret that the cash book is having a debit balance of 18,500, which we have calculated as a balancing figure between the debit and the credit side. So this is the amount with which your BRS will start. So just after amended cash book, we have prepared the bank reconciliation statement as on 31st March 2015. So again, the three columns, particulars, plus items and minus items, we have started with the balance as per amended cash book. And since it is a debit balance, so we have written debit balance. We can also write debit balance as per amended cash book. And we know that debit balance as per cash book or amended cash book is a favorable balance. Therefore, we have written the amount of 18,500 in the plus column. Then all those items which need to be plus and which added, that will be put in the plus column, and all those items which needs to be deducted will put in the minus column. So checks entered in the cash book but not sent for collection or is a minus item, it has to be deducted. So it will be put in the minus column 2000. Checks drawn but not presented for payment is to be added. So we have put it in the plus column 13,200. Then checks sent for collection but credited after 31st March 2015. Is a minus item, so we have put in the minus column 6200. Then wrong debit by bank is to be deducted further, since it is a mistake, then it will be put in the minus column 1700. So the closing of BRS will be the same as we were doing in the previous part, previous video. We will total the plus column which came to 31,700, then we will total the minus column which came to 9,900. Now on comparing, we can very well see that the plus column is more than the minus column. That means it is having a favorable balance. And since we started off with the cash book balance, so ultimately the closing balance will come with the opposite book, that is the passbook balance. And since the plus column is more than the minus column, that means there is a favorable balance. So favorable balance as per passbook, that is, can be written as credit balance as per passbook. And since it is a favorable balance, therefore it will be written on the in the plus column. The difference will be 21,800. This is basically the difference between the plus column and minus column, that is 31,700 minus 9,900. So I hope the question which we have discussed here is clear to you children, and especially the amended cash book, the rules and regulation regarding this. It is quite an important topic. What you need to remember is just merely the format and the rules regarding which items to be added and which items to be deducted. So go through the videos once again children, go through all the parts, part 1, part 2, part 3 and this part, so as to make the concepts more clear, and do practice as many questions as you can, especially the questions which are being given to you as the homework. So with this part, we come to an end to this chapter. This is the assignment. Based on this part, you have to answer the following questions in your register. You have to redo the questions solved in this video. The question, there is only one question which we have solved, so you have to redo that question in your copy on your own. And question number 2, you have to solve practical question number 25 and 26 from the chapter Bank Reconciliation Statement of Your Accounts Book by D.K. Goyal. These two questions are based on amended cash book children, and the preparation of bank reconciliation statement thereafter. So I hope you will be doing the work and you are understanding the concepts. Go through the video once again children, revise everything, revise the format, revise the items and complete all the written work. Thank you children, take care.